So hello everyone and welcome to the channel again, and in today's video I'll be showing you that how to wire up an amplifier. As I've already shown you in a previous video, this is a Pioneer 4 channel amplifier, and today I would be telling you that how to wire this amplifier and what all inputs are required by the amplifier to get working. So I'll just brief you about this. Firstly, the three inputs that any amplifier needs is the positive or the 12 volts that's coming from the battery. This is the negative terminal that needs to be ground in a secure grounding place in the vehicle, and this is the remote input. That means when the ignition turns on, then only the amp turns on. Otherwise, if the ignition is off, the amp will turn off. These are all the speaker inputs. They are marked plus minus according to all the four channels. This means one positive, one negative, one channel positive, negative, second, third, fourth, likewise. And if I'm going to do a bridge, a bridge basically means you use a positive terminal. For an example, this is channel A plus minus, and this is channel B plus minus, or plus minus likewise. So I'll be using plus of one channel and the minus of the second channel. That means two channels are being used for running one speaker. This is generally used to run subwoofers, and I'll be connecting a subwoofer to this. So I'll be using positive of one channel and the negative of the other channel. So this is all what is here, and on the other side you need to provide the RC inputs. RC inputs or high-rise audio inputs. Basically we use RC inputs a lot, like these. These are RC leads, and they on the back side of the stereo, if we use an aftermarket stereo, they also have ports like this, in which they say audio out for front, for a rear, and for subwoofer. So you simply connect the other side of the lead. They are exactly the same on the other side also. So I've already installed it in my vehicle. So you take these leads and you simply insert it on the rear side of the stereo for an channel. So I've connected subwoofer in this one. So I've connected both the leads to the subwoofer out of the head stereo. So I have the RC leads in my hand. These are the speaker connectors. They are doubled because the subwoofer is a bit heavy. So to run the subwoofer, this is the plus and the black one is the minus. I have this is the earth or the ground. So one very important tip in this is, once you install these kind of cables, you need to properly, as you can see, this is the cable here, and I have properly heat shielded the cable. And after that also I have put a thimble in it, and I have heat shrinked and used tape also, because in no way this can come out. If suddenly it comes out, there's a chance of getting fire in the vehicle. So this needs to be very properly done. This is the ground, this is the remote, this is the remote input, and this is the 12 volt. This is coming from the battery, and I'll just show you that how you need to connect, how it's basically connected to the battery. I'll just show you. So the positive lead that I was talking about is connected here. As you can see, both the leads are, because I'm running two amplifiers in this vehicle, so basically all the two wires of both the amplifiers is connected here. It is going through a fuse. I'm talking about what is a fuse and why is it used in another video. And you can see I've snitched all the wires inside the vehicle, and they are going through all the interior panels of the vehicle. And we do this, we run the positive or the power leads from the battery itself, because the amplifiers tend to draw a lot of current from the system. So direct connection from the battery is the only way to go to serve that much requirement. So now, as you have seen that how the power lead is coming from the front, so we'll be connecting the amplifier now. The car is already in ignition. So first, this is the power lead, or the lead that is coming from the battery. So what I'll do is I'll simply open this up, and I'm going to insert this inside and tight it down properly. Okay, and now we need to install the ground for this, and I'll be installing the ground likewise. these inputs may vary from vehicle to vehicle, so make sure every amplifier has its own reading here. It's, as you can see, it's saying positive 12 volts. This is the negative and this is the remote. As the vehicle is already in ignition, so if as soon as I'll connect the remote to this, you can see the amp will turn on. Just give me a second. This is, I've connected the remote also, and as you can see, the amp has turned on. And as I told you, I'll be using the bridge mode in this, so I'll be connecting the positive terminal to the positive side of the amplifier. Likewise, as I'm using the bridge mode. Bridge mode is basically required if you are connecting a subwoofer to an 4-channel or 2-channel amplifier. Otherwise, you do not need to bridge an amplifier for just running two speakers. Here you go. I'm only connecting the subwoofer to this amplifier for running all the four components. I already have another amplifier which is on the passenger side seat, and this is only for the subwoofer. In case you are planning to install speakers also, basically a 4-channel amplifier can also run two speakers. That is, I can attach one speaker here and one speaker here, and the rest two are running one subwoofer. So I've connected all the leads, and now I would be providing the input. I've selected channel B, so I will be installing both the leads to channel B. And now the subwoofer should run properly. So that's how you have to wire an amplifier. I just forgot one thing, that the ground here, I have grounded, this wire is being grounded to the seat bolt here. I removed the seat bolt. I've installed a thimble for the bolts, and I've properly grounded that to the chassis of the vehicle. And if you plan to install basically all the four speakers, or you are going to run both the channels, then you have to install another RC lead. I'll make an in-depth video regarding that also. Basically, the one RC lead represents one channel. So if you are going to use all the four channels, then you need four inputs. That is, two RC leads should be connected to this amplifier. Since I've not connected any speaker here, so just the subwoofer, so I have both the channels for the subwoofer only. So I hope you like this video. You like such kind of tutorial in which I just showed you how to connect this amplifier. And if you liked it, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and share this video if you feel like. And I'll be seeing you in the next one. Till then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.